Hey guys, JJ Racaza here, current production optic world champion. We're here at the live fire range. I'm going to show you guys a few drills that I think would really benefit a new shooter.
Brought to you by Shooters Global. We created the advanced training system and next gen shot timers to help you progress faster.
First and foremost, I want to make sure that my gun is zeroed. So I'm going to stand at about a good distance from target, whether 7 yards, 10 yards, whatever you think is a good distance for you. Maybe 5 yards would be a good distance if it's your first time coming out there to get a bearing of where your gun is. Going to load the gun and fire maybe 3 rounds on target. No time whatsoever. Paying attention to the way my sights look on target, paying attention to the way the trigger feels, and doing that 3 times, and then paying attention to where that lands on target and see if I need to make an adjustment. Then we're going to start right there. Gun's empty, loaded up. I'm going to fire 3 rounds at my own speed. I'm going to reset. All right, so I fired 3 rounds on target, just making sure that it's all on target. And if it's pretty much in the center of the alpha, I'm going to be good with that. So now that the gun is zeroed, now I'm going to start moving on to the first drill that we talked about. One of the drills that I like to use as a beginner when I was growing up is just literally working out from the holster coming into the target, firing one shot. And before I even got to there, I held the gun in my hand to get comfortable at presenting the target, firing one shot. And I'll do that over and over, and I'll show you the progression of that particular drill. First, I'm gonna do this without any time whatsoever to just kind of get a feel for it. I have a double action, single action gun. So every time I fire one shot, you're gonna see me decock the hammer and do all that. Some of you guys may not have that. You just have to put the safety up. But for me, that's my safe mode, right? So without the timer, I just want to feel for what it feels like to punch out, see my sights, feel my trigger, and fire one shot and do it over again. I'm going to do that again, punch out, feel the trigger, and fire another shot. And I'm going to just repeat that over and over so I feel a good feel on that target per se. So now punching out, firing the third shot, and I'm still pretty much achieving the right type of grouping on target when I had the shots by itself. So now I want to test that and see how fast I can actually exploit one accurate shot on target from the timer. So this is what it would work like. I have a 2 second delay. So when I press the buzzer, it'll give me about 2 seconds before it gives me the green light. Here we go. That was 1.23 seconds. That's 1.29. And that was 112. So then I can look this back later on in my app. You can see the time there, one shot, 1.12. I can look this later in the app itself, in the software, to see where the hits are and stuff like that. So I'm gonna look at that as my overall general baseline. If maybe it's too slow, maybe it's too fast. No, all right, my fastest time there was 112. The grouping's still okay on target. Maybe I can speed that up for the next round. So before I even come out the holster, I'm gonna do that again. I'm gonna see where I can pick up. Maybe I'll pick up time on the aggression, but shooting at about the same speed. So again, here's what I'll do. I'll speed up my movement, but my shooting should be about the same. So maintaining that nice grouping on target, here's what we're gonna do. And we're gonna see if that made a difference. That was a 0.92. I'm gonna try it again, see if I'm just gonna aggressively punch the gun out on target and shoot about the same exact speed. That's 0.72. That's 0.75. That's a 0.72 again. So by adjusting my movement, by just speeding up the movement on to the target and the reaction time, and then but essentially shooting at the same speed when my sights are good on target, prepping, I was able to achieve a nice grouping on target about this size, and then seeing the difference on timer. So now that I'm comfortable doing that as a beginner, maybe it's time for me to come out from the draw and see what my overall time is. So now I'm actually gonna come out from the holster and go to the target and seeing what my overall time is. I'm just gonna again prioritize my accuracy, and then I'll beat speed from there later. So now I'm gonna do the same exact target. I'm gonna shoot this from the draw. I'm still doing the same exact speed in regards to the way I'm pulling the trigger. That's a 120. So I want to have an accuracy on target, a nice group. That's a 122. And that's a 116. So there, maintaining the nice grouping on target still, I saw that from the holster, I can get a 1.2, 1.16, a 121 on target, maintaining that nice, decent center shots on target. And then I'll go, all right, 116, 120, can I speed that up? Where can I speed that up? Again, it's always in the movement, not necessarily on the shooting. So I want to speed up my reaction time, my ability to get the gun out of the holster, and seeing how this will print on target. So let's do it again. Same exact time, I was averaging about 120 and 116 there. Now I've set it up because I'm going to go after it. I'm going to get a little fast. I have a pause time at about 5 seconds. It's going to be my reset time. I have a 1.2 second limit, and I'm going to do it 3 reps with a delay of 2 seconds from my first shot. So 1.2 seconds, my goal. I'm going to try to beat that right now, and I'm going to do it 3 sets in a row. Click apply. I'm going to go right to start, and we're going to see. I'm only going to press the timer once now, and I'm just going to wait. I'm just going to wait for the next buzzer. So now I'm able to see my one shots on it from first to second to third. So my first was 106, second was 105, third was 104. But with that, by speeding it up, what happened was it allowed, all I had to do was press the button once, it was really convenient, and I was able to use the set to par set time. So now I want to be able to repeat that over and over. I had my par time at 1.2. I was able to shoot an actual shot at 1.05 and 1.04 average. But what happened is my accuracy went down a little bit. So with that said, I'm going to continue to do this exact par time that I'm doing. And I'm going to try to make sure now that since I've sped it up, I'm going to try to increase my accuracy. It's always a balance between accuracy and speed. I might bump up the repetition to 10. So I can do is 10 in a row and see what the difference is from one to the next. And what it's allowing me to do is not have to worry about the timer. All I have to do is join fire one, reset, get my mind right, do it all over again. For the beginners, this is a really good particular drill because it focuses just on one thing, presentation of the gun first, and the next thing is the draw stroke into the target. The main focus here is to be able to get good shots by speeding up your movement. Speeding up your movement, your time should dwindle down to a certain point until you can't anymore, then you'd have to speed up your shooting. But initially, maintain your level of accuracy while drawing and making sure that all the movement is fast. Once you do that correctly, you'll be able to progress really fast from there on out. But right now, I'm gonna measure my ability to shoot 2 shots really fast on target, so which works on my recoil management, and I'm also gonna work on my grip, my ability to run the trigger without disturbing my sight picture. So I'm gonna drop this. I'm gonna continue to do the same thing with the timer, the sets, but I'm gonna drop the pause time and the time limit to 1 second, so that should be good. And then I can start the video. Once I start the video, I can go right to this. I'm gonna position myself where I can see the gun on the target itself. And every time I hear a buzzer, I'm gonna fire 2 shots fairly quickly, and I'm gonna wanna see my split time, and then I'm also gonna pay attention to my hits on target. So here we go. I'm gonna press start on the timer itself, and then I'm making sure that the sights and the gun is on the frame of the phone, and then I'm gonna press start. And that should have given me my times on there. You can see the times, 0.52, 0.36, 0.16s and 0.21s is on my times there. My best split was 0.16. And so you can see here on the timer itself now, the first set was 0.18 split. The second set was 0.16 split. And the third set actually slowed down to 0.21. And then now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna review that when I get home, per se, to watch the video. And all I'm doing is watching the way the gun's recoiling. and a gun is recoiling not very much. That's all I'm looking for and wanting to see what the, just by watching this initial video, what I actually saw and recognized was something that I didn't like. I started right there without moving my feet. I was able to return it in the second one. And on the third one, you can see that my gun's getting closer and closer, and I was further back on there. So as the first target, you can see that the gun is centered on the first two shots. And then the second two shots, I was further back. So that means my stance and my posture was pushing me back a little bit. So by the end of the third shot, you can see how far the gun has now returned. It's now beyond out of the camera. So I have to fix that. And that probably caused a few of my bad shots on target. So all I gotta do is repeat that again and then make that drill better. Coming back on it, do the video again. And again, we're gonna compare the same exact thing. I'm gonna click start whenever I'm ready. I'm gonna make sure I get myself, now I'm gonna get my stance better. I'm gonna see my recoil management in regards to my gun was good, but however, I was getting pushed back. So I'm gonna drive my stance a little bit better onto the target and see if my results would be better as well. And I'm gonna maintain that same speed, 0.16 as much as I can. All right, so now that I made that adjustment from my earlier video, you can see my gun is lined up basically on that tree line. I should check my recoil management. Their recoil management was pretty decent. My split was about 0.21, very similar to the last time as last drill. I was able to get 0.19 that time, and you can see my gun is fairly in between the same exact area. And the last one, I just kind of pulled off on it. I should have followed through. But 0.19 again was my same thing. But the best thing about it is when I look at my target, my last three shots were touching from each other, doing double tap speed on it. The only thing that veered away from it was when I initially started on the previous drill, had one shot go really low. And a lot of that was probably because I didn't have my established stance. So the good thing about this is now I'm utilizing my video in regards to where my gun is set up, because this should be constant. And sometimes I get lazy and I start to rock back and further back. And the further back you have, you're compromising your structure. But if I continue to get consciously engaged on the target and bring myself back to the original stance, that will allow me to be consistent with my performance, which basically happened just now. My shots started to click closer and closer as opposed to separating. And then I was able to confirm as well how flat or how much my gun is moving around. Because if I had a bad grip, that gun would flop around. I'm looking for a gun that returns back onto the target, not a gun that flops around over returns, and not a gun that kind of just bumps up and comes back real slow, bumps up and comes back real slow. Those are not the characteristics of a good shooter that I want. I want to make that adjustment by either adjusting the pressure of my grip or the shooting stance that I want to have. Nose over the toes, spread up my feet as opposed to level. I want to be pushed back a little bit, lean forward, my nose over the toe, my toes are clamping down with the solid structure behind it. I should be able to run 2 to 3 rounds and not have to basically work on the gun pushing me back on the hill. I should be able to control that muzzle and go right back to center is what I just did. So that's one of the biggest, most important things for new shooters, because they don't have that established yet. Even for me, just doing this drill just now, watching a video, I caught myself being lazy. So that's something that I have to pay attention to as well.